I say the same things in life that I say in my songs, yeah. Once considered right and once considered wrong. My friends love my aggressiveness when I'm up on stage, pretend to take it personal when I'm up in their face. Like, it's not what you say, but how you come across, as if they never knew me from the first time we talked. The same things happen to a celebrity, I guess, where he does something wrong and the world gets upset. But if he continues to bless children and brighten up the future thick, we give him golf claps and wait for him to contradict. You don't want unity, you want individual freedom. It's not my fault we created what everyone wants to be them, and I could allow myself to see your presentation if I didn't acquire so much about our destination. Now y'all can pretend you don't feel it, but can y'all follow through? Cause you know, regardless of how it's said, the outcome's always loving you. Now ask me if I care, and I'll say I do. Fuck you, that's for my ego. I love y'all, that's personal.
But truth don't need no support, right?
Lead by example. To me, it's pretty much self-explanatory. Dang, I can't even really remember that far back. I just decided that instead of trying to constantly remind people, you know what I'm saying? We would just start doing it, just straight up. And the dopest outcome of that was this actual song, which was on 4th of July, which is Independence Day. We were all chilling here, and we decided to just do a song called Lead by Example. It's like, let's just do it. Like, let's start the process right now. And from here on out, we just lead by example. The basis of all types of leadership. You know what I'm saying? Because if you're not living up to what you're talking about, then how do you expect people to want to take to your lead? Not necessarily follow you, but to take to your lead, to stand by your side, or to have your back fully, to be like, where we stand for this too. Right? Yeah. Peace. Yeah.
Say I do. You can't claim a song, create tears. Y'all got some, just listen. Now listen to this. What do you all want to know? Well, I'm gonna tell you something.
Everybody watching this, just keep watching. You might learn something.
Exploitation. Rule number one.
Put a baby in there, make them like it.
Oh, put a baby in the video, and all of a sudden the person that they're talking about is, yeah, that's, you know what I mean? Aw, ain't that cute? A little hippie baby. We ain't no hippies. Let me tell you something. I don't even know what the fuck a hippie is. I never touched drugs in my life. That's for real. Every time you mention love, somebody always gotta mention the word hippie. I love y'all. Hippie. Known to many people as an entertainer, an activist, so to say. Whatever adjectives you guys can think of, that's pretty much what I have become for the sake of communication. I can do nothing but give thanks and just be proud for everything I've been able to push for, you know what I'm saying? And the people that have been behind what it is that we have been doing for ever since I was born, you know what I'm saying? I started these meetings. It wasn't just me. It was a guy by the name of Cleezy. He had this idea where he wanted to get a group of people together. Hip-hop practitioners. And the practitioners would basically do their thing through hip-hop and promote love and peace.
I got the notion to act upon that idea. Not just because of him, but also I received some messages within my dreams, and it stimulated me in order to create this movement.
It started out with 5 people, then it got to 10, then it got to like 40 and 50. You know, so much that we were doing like Tai Chi back in the back of the shop. This shop that you see here. The meetings aren't the same as they were. Pretty much they never stopped. It's just in a different form now. And that form now is exactly what it is that a lot of people said that they wanted to see rather than hear. You know, since we are in this visual world, she'll probably cut to some, you know, excerpts of things that we've been doing. You know what I mean? So you can see a lot more while I'm talking over the actual visuals. We started this night with the meetings in mind. And the night was given to us by a promoter by the name of Moore. Me and the Solillaquists of Sound, we started with Moore at Will's Pub in Orlando, Florida. A night called Vocalization. And Vocalization is an open mic night. But it also entails a live band, live performance as always, poetry, hip-hop, R&B, opera, reggae, wherever you want to take it, we can go there. The band will back you up in every way, shape, and form. With these meetings now taking place, now people are seeing more and hearing the same kinds of messages, just more in a rapping flow, kind of like, ah, gotta get over the hill, this legible knowledge, you come in the few, discredible, edible, sensible, for thought by decibels, that I'm an incredible source to give it to, I'm betting you. Never do seven or more people who believe in people who believe in something different. I hang with the conscious, I disagree with your avenue, agree with everything, say to be factual, really pretend to be simply means by the ego. People don't get it in black, the single, the first, the last, the last, the first, the second one, deja vu, the second one, deja vu, the second one, deja vu, the second one, deja vu. I'm climbing away, that it's not for the bottom, I gotta keep moving, the stop, stop, lost, you better never get, never get followed with you. Doing the same as other with you, let me too. Plan my schedule, and it's just set up a fucking verse, we're out of air. That's the kind of thing that we do. So now that we have your attention, we can probably show you more excerpts of some other shit that you'll love